Like, that could just be a couple of weeks' growth. Hey, how you doing?
I'm good, mate. How can I help?
My name's Tim. I'm a certified lawn detailer. I make satisfying videos cutting overgrown grass. I wanted to see if I could cut it for free for you today.
Free? No, not good.
No, you don't like free?
No.
Bad price. Why is that?
No, why do you want to give free?
I make videos cutting the grass. People like to watch.
I really appreciate what you're offering, but I feel bad actually, like you're not charging anything for
no,
that.
No, don't feel bad. I told you, that's what I do. I film it. I make satisfying videos and hopefully people watch them.
Uh-huh.
It's a much more fun way to do it. Welcome to another episode of Free Mow Fridays. This isn't the biggest yard that I've done by any means, but it doesn't mean I'm going to put any less effort into it. This could be just 2 or 3 weeks growth with this type of grass, which is Kikuyu. The weather's been perfect for it just to go crazy. I had to do a smaller yard this week just because of time constraints, so had to do something a little closer to home. These aren't rich areas, these are just newer estates. These are what all the houses look like in these areas. Regardless, it's Free Mow Fridays, which just means someone gets a surprise, a nice cleanup. Hope you enjoy the cleanup. If you like these videos, I've got another channel called Turf and Tools. The vlogs that were on this channel are now on that channel, as well as the new Turf and Tools podcast. So if you like listening to podcasts and you like talking about equipment, go check that out. Sorry, you missed a bit of mowing there. I forgot to hit record. This definitely won't look pretty when it's done. It's been mowed previously and the clipping's not collected. So there's a real build up of that here. So yeah, it's gonna look a little ugly. So in all these new estates, I believe that's a like sediment catchment pit. I think once the estate's fully built, they'll be filled in and a house built there. But yeah, I believe the developer's meant to maintain them, which obviously they don't. Imagine living next door to this. Look at the weeds you got coming through. We're gonna send them home. Thank you. I don't even feel bad about throwing that over the fence. Like, it's growing through the fence, and you should see the state that that place is kept. I feel like these are here intentionally, so I don't really want to move them. They're strategically placed. There's only so much you can do. Thank you. right, so I've come back the next day, ran out of time to do the back. This shouldn't take too long for me. Some contractors did arrive. Could take care of that. And they are just ripping in, I've got to say. I've got a lot of respect for those guys. Like, that is some tough work there. It's like 40 degrees today here as well, so big job. They've already done another one down the road. I saw it when I was coming in. The developers obviously finally put their hand in their pocket and decided to get it maintained. We do have some tomatoes, there's some weeds there, but there's also some tomatoes there, so we're going to try and steer clear of that. Thank you. So this here is the perfect example of the difference between mulch mowing and just not picking up the clippings, mowing it when it's overgrown. This is what would have been overgrown last time it was mowed. All these clippings were just left there, and it just, look what happens underneath. Not good for the lawn. Just suffocates it. So particularly, so there's nothing wrong with mulch mowing at all if you're mowing regularly, but if it's overgrown, you're not doing yourself any favors. Thank you for watching another episode of Free Mow Fridays. I hope you found it satisfying. If you did, hopefully you can follow or subscribe. If you're into equipment reviews, outdoor power equipment, go check out Turf and Tools and the Turf and Tools podcast. Until next Friday, have a good week.